But what I wanted to talk about, and I think this is going to be useful for all of you who want to make docs, is the principles of docs. Don't change even with length and such. And so I'm trying to condense about 5 weeks of lecture into the next hour, or actually let's say the next 20 minutes. And then we'll do questions and answers. So I'm going to go rather fast. And the first thing I want to note is to tell you that I've never read a book about documentary production, but I had to because I had to teach it using these books. So they gave me these books. They're really great books. I know about 14 students in December that will be offloading a few. So, but they're available at the, some of them won't. They're available at the ASU Burke store. This is a, I mean, if you want to, this is a really nice one, kind of a standard textbook. Again, that's ASU. This one, though, is something for the person who really wants to take it to the next level on shooting and editing and writing. It's a handbook. It's, you know, it has, here's diagrams of lighting and such, whereas this is more reading. And then the back half is all narratives from some of the best documentary makers in America about how they approach it and such. But let's start. I wanted to hit four categories: structure and style, characters, shooting, and editing. Structure and style, I mean, the biggest thing, and if I'm talking down to anybody that's done this already, please excuse me, but it's all storytelling. That's all you're doing the whole time is telling a story. And so think about when you're doing a doc. Yeah, you're making television, but in the end, it's got to be a good story. No one's going to hang with it if it's not a good story. And especially if it's on the net or television, your competition is fierce. So it has to be somewhat entertaining. Now that's, you know, that for history, it's like, ah, that's the bad word, you know? But the truth is, because of the wide variety of audiences that are gonna approach your docs, it's part of what makes people hang with it for 10 minutes. So there wasn't much humor in the MLK thing, but there was, you know, a little bit of humor goes a long way in your docs. So the first thing I want to talk about structure and style is, although this comes off as a visual thing, it's not just visual. Shot, sequence, scene, act. Now it's a little tough to get that in 3 acts, 5 acts into 11 minutes. But if you really looked at this MLK piece, you had an introductory section that was fairly short. You had the first act, which was Babbitt made the decision, Meekham said no, and that just sets the stage for the conflict, which is another thing every story has to have. And I remember when I was a student, I'm like, you know, I don't want all my stories to be bad. Conflict's bad. Well, the truth is, all good stories have some tension there. The tension here is, I mean, there was obvious tension, you know, the people who wanted the holiday, let's do it, and the fact that there were people who either didn't want the holiday or wanted it to be happen the appropriate way and kick it back to the legislature, going through that, you know, again. But and so then the second act. So first act is exposition, which is who, what, when, where, and why. Now, it can be a bit vague, but that's like a news story. Right at the beginning, you got to tell everybody what it's about, you know, who's involved, and you got to give them a reason to care. So what I liked about what, this is actually produced by Steve Goldstein, who's the morning guy on NPR, or, you know, local NPR, good friend of mine, and I hired him to do a lot of narration. He came in and said, you know, I'd like to do more. So I gave him a chance to do, and I thought he did a great, this is the first thing he ever did, visually. But he's a great writer, so it wasn't hard. But I like how he started it with, you know, the guy in the church. It puts you right in the place. And he's got a big smile and he's saying it was right here. Now, how did he get him to say it was right here? He probably said, what happened right here? Now, he's obviously not a gentleman that's unused to speaking right there, in fact. But, I mean, what a great way to center it and say it was right here where it was signed into law. We couldn't believe it was happening. Nice little spike of happiness. Wait, don't get too happy. So that was, you learned all that in the first minute or so, right? Well, how did it work visually? You saw him sitting in the church. You saw the church. You know, you saw footage of the past. Well, all of those, each shot, remember that wide shot of the church just zooming in? Did your brain go a little sideways? Wait a minute, what are we doing in church? But then what was delivered over that shot was the information that Babbitt called up and said, what do you think? I want to do it here. It's appropriate because it's a meeting place for your community. Do you think that's appropriate? It brings you into that place, and the next thing you know, there he is standing on the pulpit going, it was right here that happened. What else could you have done? A nice long shot of the proclamation. So he made a visual choice to tell it through people. We'll get to characters in a little bit. But that's all. That's that marriage of sound and music and visuals gave you the who, what, where, why. That also then developed into a sequence because you had shots of the church, shots of the guy at the pulpit, shots of, you know, Babbitt. That sequence you could have called the proclamation sequence. But then you get into, but Babbitt wasn't there for very long. And Meekum comes in and he rescinds it. So that could be the end and the beginning of what we then call a scene. Now the scene is more than just the church bit. The scene is, I would say that first scene would be after the original, you know, here's what the story about, was we made it a proclamation and then it went away. That's the scene. So then next, because it's short, you could almost call that act one, because it presented the debate. What do we do? There's the conflict. So at the end of act one, you were presenting the conflict that we're now gonna show you the two sides of in act two. And act two, in any doc, act one is maybe a quarter. Act three is maybe a quarter, and act two is the heart of the discussion that ultimately will climax in some sort of resolution. Now this one didn't have a very hard ending of Act Two, and part of it was because of the way everything rolled out. You know, if Meekum had lost the election and a guy came in and, you know, made the legislature do it, and it had this nice boom, and now we look back and everything's, you know, worked out well, but really he got ousted for other reasons, and it kind of got, but really the end of Act Two was, we got it passed. And then Act Three, very short, was, yeah, we got it passed. We got to think about how we had to do it. It took years to do it. The legislature didn't just say, we should do this, and did it. So there's a bit of an epilogue and a backstory. You know, this was a struggle. So, you can see how all those work through. Sequences are shorter, church. Scenes have a bigger message, the proclamation. You know, was made, then got destroyed, or got turned back. That was a scene. A series of scenes creates an act, which in a shorter piece is a little misleading because you almost only have a scene in Act One. But then there were several scenes to get us. You know, there was the national, you know, we're not going to bring our football to you. There was the stuff just showing you Meekum and Babbitt talking. That all went into this, talking about what the conflict is. And then again, Act Three was, yeah, we got it done, but it was a struggle. Okay, the one thing I've also judged, some of these, and I would say that the of the ones I've seen, the ones struggle, and believe me, this is not just for national history. It's anybody that's ever making any kind of doc, is simplifying your story. That's the challenge that everybody, they get too much. There were some kids last year or 2 years ago that wanted to do, I think it was Glen Canyon, and they were from Page. You know, so it was really important to them. But they just had so much. It was going so many places. And then there was one also on the bomb. and it went everywhere. And it just tried to tell too many stories. So one advice I would have is take your story, do your research, and that's what gets you in trouble, because now you learn all these other things. Or you could not do your research and air it as a news story, which happens every night. and then just go, hey, it's a new day. Made mistakes yesterday. One way to do that, this is a good example of it, is find the people who can tell it. Personalize it. Because you're going to listen to somebody who's passionate about it anyway. So simplify the story by finding the people.